All right, in this video series, I'm going to work through some dosing calculations for those of you who can use a little extra help with that. I have 9 problems that I'm going to work through. I have these problems posted on my website, leveluprn.com, so you can print them out from my website and kind of work through them alongside of me. I also have the answer key, so if you want to work through the problems independently and just check your answers, then you can just open the answer key and see how you did. So I'm just going to take one problem at a time, and I'll show you how I like to go through the problems, okay? So the first problem I'm going to go over is how to calculate an oral dose. So if your doctor prescribes like a tablet or a capsule, how do you calculate how many tablets or capsules your patient should get? So in this particular problem, the order was for 0.4 grams of this medication every 8 hours. And what we have on hand are capsules with 200 milligrams in each capsule, okay? So let's work through this. So our order is, what we need to give the patient is 0.4 grams. And I can already see that because my capsules are in milligrams, I'm gonna need to convert these grams to milligrams, okay? So I'm gonna multiply 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligrams. So at this point, I can cross off this gram and this gram, right? One's on top, one's on bottom, and I have milligrams. Now I need to figure out how many capsules my patient should get. So I would multiply this, 200 milligrams are in one capsule, and my milligrams are gonna cross off, and then I would do my multiplication, which is 0.4 times 1,000, and then divide by 200, and that would give me 2 capsules that I need to give my patient for the dose that is ordered. So that's problem one. All right, now I'm on problem two. So we are gonna calculate an oral dose again, but this time we have an order for a liquid medication. So in this particular case, we have an order for 0.5 grams of a liquid medication to be administered every 12 hours. And what we have available is this medication in the following concentration. So we will have 250 milligrams within 5 milliliters of liquid. So the question is, how many milliliters should we administer? So again, I'm gonna start with what's ordered, which is 0.5 grams. And you can see by what's available that I'm gonna have to convert again to milligrams. So I'm gonna multiply 1,000 milligrams over 1 gram. And now I have milligrams. But I need to find out how many milliliters I need to give the patient. So I'm gonna multiply this times 250 milligrams is in 5 milliliters. I can cross off my milligrams, and if I multiply this out, I will get milliliters, and in this case, I get 10 milliliters. So you can do this with your calculator. You would multiply 0.5 times 1,000 times 5, divide by 250, and that will give you 10 milliliters. So again, I'm starting with the ordered dose, and I'm just doing conversions to get to the unit of measure that is asked for in the problem. So that is problem two. We'll pick it up with problem three next. All right, the third type of problem I'm gonna work through here is calculating an IV, IM, or subcutaneous dose. So in this particular example, the doctor has ordered 5,000 units of heparin to be given every 8 hours. What we have on hand are 10,000 units per milliliter. Okay, so per milliliter of liquid, there are 10,000 units of heparin. And we wanna know how many milliliters should we give with each dose, and then how many milliliters we're gonna give over that 24-hour period, okay? So let's first talk about what we're going to be giving per dose. So again, the order is for 5,000 units, and what we have is 10,000 units in 1 milliliter. So our units cross out here. We take 5,000 divided by 10,000 and we get 0.5 milliliters. That's how much we're giving with each dose, okay? We're giving that every 8 hours. So to calculate how many milliliters we're gonna give over a 24-hour period, we're gonna take that 0.5 milliliters that we are giving per dose, we're giving that every 8 hours, and we're gonna multiply that times 24 hours, right? And our hours cross off. And we're gonna end up with, if you do the math here, 0.5 times 24 divided by 8 ends up being 1.5 milliliters total that we're giving over a 24-hour period, okay? So that is problem 3. We'll move on to problem 4 next.